It's your boy, Brother Big, back with another episode of The Big Talk. First and foremost, shoutouts, hats off to Ali 2020. Ali 2020 telah pun berakhir dengan jayanya. So shoutout to Kamar Seni, Hashtag Media dan Angkasa. Dan juga tim-tim yang bekerja keras di belakang tabir. You know who you are. Congratulations, alright? So, korang tengok tak show? I sure did. So, kita akan recap balik daripada first sampai last. Before we proceed, congratulations Margosa on winning the first place title. Alamak, juara Ali 2020, juara ulung. Congrats to Margosa. Alright, so let's recap from the beginning. Kita ada red cap tu Freddus.
Yo, red cap.
Di mana kalau ada crowd kiri kanan, red carpet tu mungkin akan lagi meriah mungkin. They made their way from red carpet. You know, kita tengok orang-orang berjalan macam diorang feel habis lah macam tu award show betul. Sampai kat red carpet punya pit stop, interviewed by Agam and Akila of Rakita. Shout out to Rakita, music paling lead. So daripada situ, kita move on to the beginning of the show. The show started wonderfully in my opinion dengan kehadiran Senja dan Time Machine. They brought us back to good old memories from back in the days dengan lagu-lagu medley from past indie bands. Medley yang diorang bawa termasuklah lagu-lagu daripada Estrella, Butterfingers, Mi Uncle Hussein, Couple, Hujan, Grey Sky Morning, OAG pun ada. Ush, that was a good performance from the two all girl bands. So shout out to Senja and Time Machine. So we made our way to performances yang kita nampak yang I have my personal preferences. Aku personally suka Pelukan Angkasa. The cover for that was like, the arrangement for that was according to abang of SOG. Mungkin lepas ni tak buat dah. Shout outs to SOG for that arrangement. Sheila Hamzah semua tunjuk effort gila babi. Yeah. So memang cliche sebab ramai yang suka, but aku pun suka. So I can say, alright. So that's from the SOG part. Kita performances daripada Bichu yang always giving lively performances. Crinkle Cut yang di mana diorang interview sebelum perform, yang macam diorang enter to like expose their music and hopefully gain fans. Well, good news, Crinkle Cut, you've gained a new fan in me, Crinkle Cut baby. And then kita ada sendu session with Hasha Roslan and Hedy Moru. Jika Ini Yang Terbaik, ya Allah, that song really got to me. And it was on repeat on my Spotify playlist for quite some time. So shout outs to them. Orkes Haris Adin, Anina Hasnol, good performance. Nusa Rasa and the Patient Sisters bringing good harmonies straight to your face. Ha! Budak nakal, what can I say? They came through with the wardrobe, they came through with the performances every single time. At least this is what I think. Budak Nakal tak pernah tak bagi 150%, always 150 and more. So shout outs to Budak Nakal. So Margosa, what do you think of that intro? Nampak macam dark kan, tapi actually lagu cakap pasal penawar. Ocean Lights, yo, his falsetto aku personally suka. Memang dia bagi yang macam tu kan. So shout outs to Ocean Lights as well. And leading to all of that, Teman Lelaki, oh jangan lupa Teman Lelaki dengan Nama Tuhan, Allahu Akbar. The song was like, how would you say, it's been a while where an award show where lagu-lagu yang dipertandingkan, like kau boleh feel the whole lineup, the whole set, the feel is there. So shout outs to indie music scene for bringing that to life. Come on now, come on. And Kapau, oh my god, Kapau punya inside joke. PM apa yang tak naik-naik? Aku tak tahu, Ana Ibrahim. Hey, PM tepi. Shout out to Mika Pau for that. Lepas ni mungkin aku nak challenge dia. Challenge dia ke teki lah. But oh my god, shout out Carol from Temjin and Mafis for jumping in to play in the slot of where it was supposed to be another person. But all is good. They did their thing. They performed their hearts out. Like I said, kita dah go through a lot during this pandemic to not have that feel again. But Ali kind of brought it to me, brought it back for all of us. So thank you. Aku pun share the live chat, you know, mixed reviews on the feedbacks from the people watching. But nonetheless, it's a free world, freedom of speech. Say what you want, but at the end of the day, kita semua enjoy and enjoy to the fullest. So dah cover semua tu, MC dah naik apa keluar semua. Ingatkan, that's it. We thought like we had only Senja and Time Machine, but guess what? Kita ada Couple. Highlight of the night for me, where Syahrin played drums sebelah tangan je. Shout out to you, Syahrin. And it's good to see them again. Syahrin, Ariana, Aidil and Izzat. Those are my peeps, my people. Kan? Aidil yang macam tu pun rupa-rupa pun kaki wrestling tau. Lagi the flashback, kalau ada live crowd tu, dah memang jerit, we want more, we want more lah. That I can assure you, in terms of hadiah-hadiah. Aku baca kat live chat ada yang cakap, itu je ke? Ini je ke? But the cash prize itself, they make of what they get. Alhamdulillah for me. Packages yang datang sekali dengan cash prize tu, you've got recording packages, you know, mixing and mastering packages from various studios. So shout out to them. Contoh macam 2105, Jerry Wong, from Karma Seni, shout out to Eji Koko. And speaking of which, kita punya juri-juri, we had the Otai M. Nasir in the ranks of the jury. So it's something that kita patut banggakan. Dan aku juga baca tweet dari, di Twitter daripada Aubrey Suwito yang mengatakan masa depan muzik ini cerah. Keep it up. Dan juga khabar angin kuat mengatakan Ali 2021 is happening. So untuk bands yang nak standby, yang fikir 2020 punya Ali ni really did something for the bands yang dah bertanding, and you think you have what it takes, apa lagi, cari-carilah platform, cari-carilah website ke apa berkenaan Ali 2021. Find out how to submit your songs, or kalau belum buat lagu, sekarang is the time to write songs, record songs, give your best quality, give your best effort, sacrifice your time, your money. Itu yang penting, kerjasama, teamwork. Because you never know, Ali 2021 might be bigger, and usually that's the case. Can you have me next year? Boleh. With bands, you gotta have a representative. Band-band yang dekat Ali tu kebanyakan pada diorang ada representative mewakilkan diorang untuk membawa nama diorang ke depan. Macam wakil untuk PR diorang dekat Ali ke apa ke, to get more shows and what not. Kita bercakap tentang a band manager. So cakap pasal band manager, aku ada tetamu khas lepas ini yang boleh lagi mungkin memberi aspek yang lebih mendalam ataupun cerita pengalaman dia tentang dia manage this one legendary band. At least to me, legendary lah. So up next, our special guest. Let's go. Yo guys, welcome back to The Big Talk. It's your boy Brother Big. Sekarang saya ada special guest di sebelah saya. Show your love for Mr. Ipin.
Hello
Ipin, apa khabar? Assalamualaikum.
Alhamdulillah, assalamualaikum.
Untuk mereka yang mengenali Ipin, mesti dah ramai kan? Macam aku confirm lah kenal Ipin. You know, we go way back. But yeah, thanks for being here first and foremost again, Ipin. Before kita carry on to the nitty gritty lah, kata the UK people ke apa kan, how's everything during PKP ni?
Sihat lah, tough times. I think semua orang pun tengah menghadapi kesukaran.
Yep.
But dia tengah mood, survival mood lah.
Oh yes.
Yeah, kita tak boleh nak buat apa. Benda ni global, it's not independent ni issue, individual.
Yes,
so nak buat, nak tak nak kena survive lah kan.
Yes, some say it's struggling but surviving.
Yeah.
But we keep on fighting.
Yeah.
Okay, as all of you may or may not know, Ipin is the band manager of the band Hujan.
Yes.
Alright. So first and foremost, apa progress Hujan? Perkabaran terbaru?
Hujan sekarang ni sebab PKP. Mm-hmm. So kita tengah, right now kita tengah plan something, a project.
Alright.
So aku tak boleh nak disclose lagi.
Okay, no worries, no worries.
Project apa? But satu project yang agak interesting, susah and complex and memakan masa yang banyak untuk aku lah.
Alright.
Aku pening lah buat benda ni.
But it's good for us to stay tuned.
Yes.
Follow dorang on their social media platform.
If benda ni dah keluar,
yes,
tiket dah jual.
SOP compliant?
Of course.
Itu yang penting sekarang. Kita pun macam
whatever it is, safety number one, brother.
Safety number one, brother. Macam Ipin cakap, struggling but surviving, but at the same time, we don't want to pay any compound lah.
Yes.
Of course. Why not we start from your journey on becoming Hujan punya manager. Bagaimana mulanya menjadi manager kepada orang cakap, some might say one of the current band yang terunggul di Malaysia sekarang ni?
Aku sebenarnya tak plan pun nak jadi band manager.
Okay.
So aku start mula-mula aku jadi driver, sort of driver.
Okay.
Because no, time tu dia tak ada kereta.
Okay.
So aku ada kereta.
Alright.
So dia nak pergi show, aku bawa dia. So ikutlah bawa dia pergi show. And then aku ingat yang betul-betul first aku ikut Hujan, aku jual, aku jadi merch team, merch boy lah.
Wow.
Untuk check rock tour dekat utara, Penang and Kedah. So tu first yang aku ikut band, yang betul-betul ikut pergi luar KL lah. Before that aku just drive no around KL. Daripada merch tu, and then aku start lepak dengan orang, and then first aku jadi Noh punya roadie.
Okay.
Tapi aku ada masalah, so aku tak main gitar.
Okay,
faham. So aku memang buta lah gitar ke, kalau so aku main benda aku tak boleh.
Kita barat nyanyi je lah boleh.
Aku nyanyi pun tak boleh.
Alah, nyanyi for fun boleh tapi kan?
Tak boleh.
Tak boleh? Okay,
tak boleh. Aku memang, aku ni orang tak ada talent. So aku memang tak reti benda-benda ni.
Talent
so,
elsewhere lah, Pin. Talent elsewhere.
So aku tak boleh tune gitar benda, tapi aku boleh set up. But okay, aku tak boleh main gitar. So right, I cannot tune the guitar, so what not. So dari situ then aku tolong, aku pernah tolong-tolong arm sikit. And then aku pernah jadi Dimas punya tech. So actually keyboard lagi senang kan. And from there aku Dimas, bila Dimas join balik, then dia suruh aku tolong in terms of promo. Jadi okay, promo manager lah.
Alright.
But aku promo ni aku terus terang aku tak berapa pandai.
Alright.
Because I need to handle with a lot of press kan.
Yes, correct.
And then hujan pun band yang agak besar, so banyak benda nak kena buat lah in terms of promo. So after promo manager, aku handle hujan punya shows, jadi road manager diorang lah. So basically the team, the production and what not lah of live shows. So after that Dimas balik Bandung, then aku naik jadi manager hujan. Proses macam mana aku naik tu aku pun tak sedar.
Okay,
dia just sing macam tu je.
Alright.
So aku pun tak ada, aku tak rasa, aku tak ingat, maybe ada tapi aku tak ingat yang kena interview dengan band ke benda. Aku tak pernah ingat benda tu, just macam jom lah jalan lah. So macam aku kerja dengan orang pun dia tak ada interview pun, dia tak ada macam okay apa pengalaman anda untuk ni. Ada. So aku rasa hujan ni dia satu band yang sangat spontaneous.
Okay.
So dia just go with the flow lah.
Yeah,
so
nice.
Aku rasa sebab aku just mungkin rezeki and luck aku ada dekat the right place at the right time lah.
Yeah,
mungkin sebab muka aku yang situ. So dia orang pun dah tak boleh buat apa kan. So dia orang macam kau lah, kau jadi. Aku rasa lah benda tu. So aku tak tahu qualification untuk masuk orang aku tak tahu lah benda tu. Aku just aku go dengan guts aku. And then aku ingat ada this one time aku intern dekat Media Prima.
Okay.
So after internship aku dapat few offers untuk work as a staff lah dekat Media Prima. And then aku ingat lagi one of it was Jibam.
Okay, Jibam.
Jibam was one of the producer yang invite aku untuk kerja lah. So aku macam okay. And then aku ingat aku jumpa ada dua lah ni, arwah Abang Dim Ramboy.
Alright.
Dengan arwah Abang Bob Kuman. So dua-dua ni aku lepak lah kan. So aku tanya dia, bang macam mana lah tu nom pun macam tanya, nak tak jangan balik dengan orang benda semua kan. So aku macam aku tanya dia macam, bang saya patut pergi sebab of course untuk kau umur yang 20-21 kau dapat offer kerja, ada gaji kan, tentu tak banyak pun tapi kau rasa KL tu kau punya lah. Kau ada duit apa?
Yes.
Kau daripada kau tak ada duit langsung pergi ke, at least kau dapat something.
Yeah.
Kan? So kau rasa macam kau nampak duit lah. So aku tanya dia macam okay, aku patut pergi duit ke aku patut pergi benda yang aku suka, which aku first of all aku fans hujan, aku suka gila hujan.
Okay.
So aku suka, aku minat kan lagu diorang kan. So aku ingat arwah Abang Din dengan arwah Abang Bok dia cakap okay, go with something yang kau suka so that kau tak pressure bila kerja. Duit tu mungkin tak banyak tapi insyaAllah kalau kau suka, kau kerja keras, rezeki tu datang. So dari situ aku fikir like, macam okay lah. Aku pun cakap kat orang kat Media Prima aku nak pergi sambung belajar. So aku, okay, dia orang semua kira sini aku apa. Aku tak nak lah kan. Cakap, saya tak nak kerja abang. Jadi dia orang ingat macam, budak ni apa hal ni, belagak kan. Jadi tu aku macam, aku pun, parents aku pun tanya aku macam, okay, kau nak buat apa? Kau nak kerja ke? Kau nak sambung belajar ke? Apa benda? Tapi kau kena buat something lah. So aku pun tak tahu, tentu aku rasa jiwa pun muda sikit. Aku tak tahu apa aku cakap kat parents aku. Aku macam, Aku ada lah nak buat something. Tapi one day aku akan buktikan yang apa aku buat ni is worth something lah.
Oh, you never showed them in the beginning secara no, detail kau buat
tak,
apa?
Tak, dia orang ingat aku keluar.
Okay.
Aku tak, aku sebab benda tak confirm pun aku tak nak. Aku tak suka put high hopes kat orang.
Correct. Kan.
So pergilah. So tu my side of story lah. So aku macam okay, aku ikut lah hujan. So alhamdulillah. Sebab tu sampai sekarang aku amat bersyukur dengan nasihat daripada dua ni lah, arwah lah. So arwah Abang Dim Rambut dengan arwah Abang Bok Kuman. So itulah. So dari situ aku macam okay lah, jalan lah.
Wow.
I think hujan is very dear to me.
Yes.
Because aku,
I can see that.
Aku basically aku membesar dengan diorang lah. Diorang tu Diorang tu campur Dimas, diorang tu belum macam abang aku lah. So aku, sebab diorang kan agak old school kan, agak tua sikit. So aku muda, aku paling muda, diorang dah tua. So aku kira aku ni membesar, aku ikut diorang lah. And aku pun bernasib lagi, again aku pun bernasib baik diorang ni orang kan. So kalau tak, kau imagine kau umur 20 siul kan, kau boleh jadi tak jadi orang tau. Sebab kau, ya life kau, kau bukan kat rumah pun kan. So most of the time kau kat luar kan. So kalau diorang ni tak orang, aku tak jadi orang lah.
Yes.
So aku bersyukur on benda tu lah.
It's safe to say at an early age you got yourself into this lah. You, orang kata, voluntarily got yourself involved.
Serah tengkuk lah.
Okay. So but sebab okay, because one thing that will lead to this next question. First I want to, I want to ask you, like at that early age, 2021, most people that age is either college slash nak enjoy ataupun whole college ataupun nak enjoy. That's mostly yang kita nampak lah. Not to point fingers ke apa lah. But for me it's just, I'll give you a heads off to having to decide there and then what you wanted to do. Heads off, I like that determination. Next question, detik pertemuan kau dengan Noh, first jumpa tu, dia terasa nak macam tergerak hati nak ikut tu, bila?
Aku first aku nampak Noh, aku tak kenal pun dia siapa. Ha, tentu. So aku dulu, kawan-kawan aku semua dancer tau. So diorang ni b-boys lah.
Okay.
So diorang pun banyak backup untuk some big artists lah kan. So aku ikut diorang pergi show saja, pergi tengok diorang perform. Kau tak tahu apa kan, kau at that age yang kau nak keluar je, tapi kau tak kisah apa kau buat. Duit tak ada, so kita follow lah diorang. So aku nampak satu group hip-hop tau. So aku macam, siapa mamat ni, asal dia tak hip-hop lah? Kenapa dia tak seluar baggy? Kenapa dia tak, kenapa dia lain? Dia empat orang kan? Empat orang kat rasa. Dia seorang lain. Ha, yang lain tu semua at that time kan, semua pakai seluar baggy lah, baju
FUBU ke apa semua tu kan.
Apa, baju basketball. Benda mamat ni pakai jaket, seluar skinny ke topi. Macam siapa mamat ni kan? Macam okey lah, not bad lah kan group ni. Aku macam okey. Lepas tu and then kawan aku yang dancer ni, dia, aku tak tahu macam mana dia kenal Noh. So time tu dah lama juga after that. And then dia kenal Noh. Kita ni duduk kat Kelana Jaya.
Alright.
So tempat kita orang selalu lepak ni dekat dengan Taman Bahagia.
Okay.
Okay. So Noh dulu naik LRT apa?
Naik LRT Taman Bahagia tu?
So dia akan turun Taman Bahagia. So kawan aku kacau, ya jom lah lepak dulu. So lepak, lepak, lepak. So kita jumpa you, so bawa Noh. Dia kata, oh band dia hujan. So kita orang, aku dengar lagu cak, best oh, lagu ni best kan. Cak dia, oh shock lah. So tapi tentu hujan pun dah tengah gila babi lah.
Okay.
Tengah-tengah dah zaman tu, aku rasa tahun 2007 macam tu, so hujan pun dah naik. And then,
oh yes, because few years after that dorang main Planet Hollywood apa?
Lebih kurang lah. Aku tak ingat in detail lah.
Alright, okay.
Time frame dia gitu-gitu lah.
Yes.
And then aku dulu college dekat MIIM, MIM.
MIM,
So senior aku, Fungus, Faris Fungus tu semua senior aku lah. So dulu at that lebih kurang timing-timing gitu yang kita dah tahu tu hujan tu siapa, cabut gila babi band ni kan. So sini aku, kita orang punya college, one of the syllabus dekat satu sem, aku rasa sem 5 kot, kau kena produce a talk show.
Oh okay.
Okay.
Wow.
So at that time hujan lah, Yuna, Ochintaku memang selalu gila datang college aku lah. Sebab dia buat talk show tu kan. So it's a mock up talk show tapi with a proper production lah. So aku rasa Faris kot yang panggil Noh kan, datang untuk talk show dia. So aku kat situ aku jumpa, borak dengan Noh, benda-benda macam tu. And then dia, Noh pernah perform kat college aku. So dari situ aku dah tahu benda ni semua. And then cuma yang buat aku kenal betul Noh is my friend dia, dancer ni lah. So dia yang macam okay ni Noh, kita lepak satu kali. Tapi pun tak adalah lepak hari-hari, macam ada time-time yang kita lepak. So dari situ kenal Noh. And then tu lah, Noh tu, aku nak pergi show lah, tak ada kereta lah, jom lah aku bawa kau lah. So dari situ lah, dari situ lah bawa. So saya tak cakap first, aku start sebenarnya driver dia sebenarnya bukan driver pun, aku rasa sebenarnya dia guna dengan aku lah sebenarnya lah, secara jujur lah aku rasa. Free apa?
Yelah, tapi it was the start of something beautiful lah. Sampai ke hari ni kan, Alhamdulillah.
But then it was not planned lah.
It was not planned, yes. Aku rasa
semua kerja Tuhan lah.
Yes, aku rasa sometimes work, benda yang kita tak plan tu yang longer lasting.
InsyaAllah.
InsyaAllah, sampai bila-bila. Okay, Pete, let's carry on lah. Okay, that's the story of Noh lah kan. So, in the band, confirm lah, ada bandmate kan. Like, you know, Hujan, no AG, Izzat, Jay and
Zach
and people that come on and off session semua tu kan. Macam mana kau as a manager bahagikan diri kau untuk communicate dengan band? Like, is it strictly or like go with the flow macam aku cakap tadi tu?
Strictly tu macam mana?
Kalau macam, okay, like what you have to say to the band is like when you say A is A. Tak ada macam when you say A but then you say go with the flow kan. Kalau let's say tengah buat A tu terjadi B, then you but you still okay with it. So are you between going on more to strict, let's say macam army style ke dengan band tu, ataupun macam macam tadi go with the flow because you said Hujan is a spontaneous band.
Yeah,
but how you portray yourself to the band?
It depends.
Okay.
With Hujan it depends. Aku rasa at this stage diorang semua dah very professional. So when it comes to work, everyone knows their kerja.
Okay.
Everyone knows their tanggungjawab.
Yes.
And so because Hujan, we work in a very, I can say, quite huge team now.
Okay,
so
yes,
everyone dah tahu apa benda kau kena buat. So let's say katakan ada show. So selalunya aku akan cakap macam, okay, aku punya message is untuk semua orang. So aku tak ada macam no aku pergi call time lain, am aku pergi call time lain.
Okay.
So diorang semua sekarang ni alhamdulillah semua menjaga call time. I think semua pun dah kahwin kan.
Yes.
And diorang pun dah tua kan. So aku rasa dah okay. So aku akan cakap, okay, call time is at, let's say call time is at 2, our sound check is at 3. So they know that you have that 1 hour for you to do whatever you want.
Yes.
3 is on check kan, katakan macam tu. So macam diorang ni, diorang especially no, dia takkan lambat. Sebab tu kalau dengan no, kalau kau call time pukul 2, dia akan sampai pukul 1.
Okay.
1 atau 1 setengah dia dah sampai lah. Kau pun tahu dia macam mana.
Yes, yes.
Kalau show tu show dia, let's say Hikari punya benda, aku time pukul 2, pukul 8 pagi, pukul 10 pagi dia dah sampai sana, dia nak tengok kedai dia set up, dia know it's like that.
Yes.
And so I just need to know their characters lah. So instead of aku nak kena macam mana aku portray diri aku dengan orang, sama je, cuma aku kena tahu okay, karakter dia ni macam mana. Tapi macam alhamdulillah diorang tak ada masalah disiplin, so senang untuk aku.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah kan. So diorang menjaga call time. Tapi of course sekali dua kali semua manusia pun. Sometimes kereta kau rosak. Sometimes you know like ada hal lain, emergency benda tu kita faham lah. But then most of the time I think like 95% diorang akan, diorang, aku tak ada masalah yang macam oh alamak soundcheck aku pukul 3, pukul 3 diorang kat rumah lagi. Aku alhamdulillah setakat ni aku belum belum ada benda tu lagi lah. Kita orang yang kena tunggu macam pukul 3 kita sampai. Sebenarnya organizer ingat kita orang lambat, dia beritahu aku sejam awal. So kita orang kena tunggu lah sejam. Benda-benda macam tu lah. Siapa yang selalu dengan kita, kita orang tahu macam okay, diorang ni diorang takkan lambat. Pukul 3 kita orang jalan. So sebab aku tak tahu, mungkin again, mungkin sebab aku besar dengan diorang. So sebab diorang pun jarang lambat, so aku pun kena jaga time aku lah. Sebab aku tak, for me time is gold lah.
Oh yes, nah, time so is gold, time is money.
Kalau aku tak suka bila benda aku plan habis pukul at a certain time, biar kau habis lambat. So once kau habis lambat, kau akan kacau jadual kau satu hari tu. Kau lambat satu benda, kau akan lambat benda-benda lain tu lah. So aku tak suka benda tu lah. So alhamdulillah okay, aku okay lah. Let's say some pick up terjadi, yes, kau datang, benda katakan kau pergi satu show, benda tu tak siap, we just tell them lah. That one kita go with the flow lah. Macam hey, aku tak boleh nak buat apa je kan, ada problem apa, tak apa, trip apa benda ke whatever kan. So kalau diorang kat rumah, aku cakap okay, kau stay kat rumah, aku akan beritahu bila kau patut datang. So aku boleh gauge time tu macam mana lah.
From all those stories yang you cakap tadi, it's safe to say that kalau nak approach korang, kan setengah orang takut nak approach kan.
Kenapa?
Setengah fan segan lah, more to segan
approach the band.
Approach the band. But but some say, saja aku nak select topik ni kan, when approaching a band, it's nothing wrong when you want to approach the others of the in the team.
Oh yeah.
Aku rasa ada yang takut nak approach kau. Tak tahu lah, in my knowledge lah. But guys, you see how he's talking to me. Because Ipin, when he works, he works. I've dealt with that face to face. But nothing taken, because it's work. So relating to again you as a manager, your role lah kan. Tadi you dah sedikit banyak cakap pasal your role in the band as a manager, but is there anything more in your role as a manager as to just keeping the call time, keeping the band happy. Macam kalau ada masalah, you just tell them just stay home, calm down. And anything more than that, like
banyak ah. So basically, role as a manager untuk aku lah. Manager is there to manage lah.
Okay.
So it's not just about call times and to schedule apa benda tu semua. It's one thing. Another thing is aku kena execute whatever band punya ideas. So let's say dia TG cakap, oh, aku nak bikin benda ni lah, benda. So aku kena cari jalan how to execute dia lah. So and then plus because aku ada goal aku sendiri lah. So one of it is aku nak hujan ada our own production team which is ready anytime lah. Kita nak jalan show, kita ada, and alhamdulillah we are almost there. So we have a very huge, for me is a huge team lah.
Yes,
so
yes.
Kita ada everything, kita ada in-house, kita ada our own team. So in terms of sound engineers, we have our own lighting programmers.
Yes,
we have our own VJ, we have our own guitar techs, drum techs, we have our own stage hands.
Yep.
You name it, we have it lah. So that's why bila basically aku punya goal ialah aku nak band hanya focus on playing music. That's it.
Yes.
So diorang diorang punya guitar tech, even kalau tanya no, aku tak rasa gitar dia tali berapa pun dia tak tahu kan. So everything is tech dia settlekan lah. And so bagi aku tu sangat penting because diorang kena fokus main lah. Because diorang punya tanggungjawab ialah to play well and to entertain the audience.
Yes.
The team punya responsibility is to make sure the band is comfortable and so that everyone can enjoy the show lah.
Yes.
So that's why aku pada mana aku pergi, aku prefer untuk bawa team sendiri lah. Tak kisah mana lah. Except for overseas of course and whatnot.
Yes, of course.
But then kalau dalam Malaysia, wherever we travel, kita akan travel dengan team ni lah. So selalunya
same faces.
Yes. So selalunya kita ada hujan tu pun orang kan. So selalunya kita orang macam our team at least 16-20 packs. So we have
I believe so. Yeah, I've seen it. I think maybe more pun pernah tengok. Yeah. But
because now we have our own security team.
Yes.
Because crowd dia semakin melia buas kan. So at
once
least
or twice I pun pernah selit tolong, but it's all in a good day's work.
Yeah, because
know?
Like I said lah, you know, safety first kan.
Yes, of
course. Boleh enjoy, but then we need someone to betul-betul observe and tengok safety of the crowd, safety of the band, safety of the team and whatnot lah. So because aku benda ni dia sebenarnya tentu benda ni jadi sebab dulu kita pernah hujan, pernah main dekat APM tau. Anugerah Planet Music kat Jakarta.
Okay.
So tentu aku borak dengan manager or someone lah from band Kotak.
Okay.
Kotak from Jakarta kan. So dia tanya aku, oh korang datang bawa apa? So aku cakap lah, oh aku kita datang bawa gitar and effects lah. Oh okay. Itu dia orang pun cakap, dia cakap, oh kalau dia orang travel di KL pun macam gitu lah kan. So dia cakap, oh kalau di Malaysia, aku cakap, ah, lebih kurang lah, sama lah. So dia cakap kat aku, oh kalau Kotak tu, dia travel bawa toiletries je. Yang lain tu semua endorse, semua ada ni. So aku macam, tentu aku macam, eh, sial lah kan. Asal aku tak boleh buat kan. Cakap, aku tentu aku cakap, eh, satu hari aku nak, macam kena ada benda ni lah kan. So diorang memang bawa baju diorang ke kan. So yang lain tu semua orang settle kan. For them lah.
Macam so, rider lah, some sort.
Lebih kurang lah. So, because right now, alhamdulillah, rezeki pun ada, then we can at least, you know, kita buka peluang pekerjaan untuk orang lain lah kan. So, we have bigger teams means bigger job opportunities for everyone else lah. Then now, now we all dah jadi family lah kan. So, and then the band pun akan macam, okay, let's say they want to do something right. Okay, kata aku AJ cakap, okay, aku nak pakai barang ni. So dia akan discuss dengan sound engineers. So cakap, okay, aku nak pakai barang ni, macam mana? So nanti Syafiq, Zunun and Bijan, or Bijan dia akan, diorang yang akan discuss okay macam ni nak pakai barang ni okay ke tak, benda-benda ni semua macam tu. Macam okay, kita orang nak upgrade wireless system. So our sound engineers yang akan recommend apa nak patut pakai. So sebab diorang lebih tahu on barang apa yang is up to date and apa yang compatible, apa benda tu semua. So kita discuss as one team lah. So benda tu yang aku nak lah, and alhamdulillah we are achieving to that
goal. Yeah, but because I personally feel like when you have like a team of 20 and then macam you cakap sound engineers you yang suggest you ni, and then when you test sendiri pun is in-house testing, you sendiri tengok, maybe know sendiri ada situ boleh tengok, so it's good lah. So you dapat first hand of like let's say testing, and then you first hand tahu terus, you tak payah nak dengar daripada suara 2 atau suara 3, which is very good, which I think pretty much sums up a lot of things. Like if the viewers maybe tak tahu like apa pentingnya the band manager, so Ipin baru just explain I think sikit je tu, because kalau buka cerita Ipin lagi show ni jadi 2 jam lah. Kerja kena letak set up sofa belakang ni ke apa, nak bagi Ipin lagi comfortable kan, right? Like real drink coffee maybe for Ipin, you don't know, because this pretty much sums up what Ipin has been saying. But again I say it's not everything, Ipin, because some things must remain secret, I guess.
Yes.
Because alright, your personal opinion lah, pendapat kau lah Ipin. As a band nak berjaya, berjaya pun depends on what skill they want to reach lah in the near future kan. Manager ni kena ada untuk ke depan. Yes or no?
Okay, first of all, berjaya tu is very subjective.
Exactly, that's what I said. For the for certain band punya skill tu, what they want in the future, yes.
I think untuk ada band manager penting, but to have a very good and trustworthy is another thing lah.
Oh, yes.
So
I agree.
Bagi aku, kau kena tahu bila kau nak ada band manager. It's not kau kena ada orang. So macam bagi aku, sebab No AG diorang dah lama dalam scene, industri ni lah kan. So diorang dah jumpa semua benda. So basically kau tak boleh game diorang.
Of course.
Faham tak? Because diorang diorang dah tahu lah. So sometimes aku pun diorang yang ajar, Capin kau kena buat gini-gini, kau tak boleh buat macam ni, kau kena buat macam tu. So aku pun dalam proses pembelajaran lagi. Aku tak ada experience buat benda ni. Aku belasah je kan, aku jalan and then diorang guide, Dimas guide semua. So benda-benda macam tu lah. So macam band, kau kena tahu bila kau nak. Bagi aku, macam mana kau nak tahu bila kau dah tak boleh handle barang? Katakan kau ter double book. Kau ter double book, kau ter miss interview ke, kau ter ni, then you need a band manager lah. So basically kau kena tahu kau nak, kau perlukan PA or kau perlukan band manager. You need someone to assist you or you need someone to manage you.
Manage and or assist.
It's two different thing. So let's say you, kau boleh katakan you have a lot on your plate lah, but then kau rasa kau boleh manage, cuma aku perlukan someone untuk drive kau ke sana ke, to run errands for you ke, to you know, to take photos for you ke whatever, then you, you have a PA or whatever lah. So but then kau dah terlalu banyak, so kau dah tak tahu dah macam mana lah. Show ni katakan satu hari kau ada dua show, esok tu kau ada lagi dua show, kau pun dah serabut. Kau nak kena, imagine you have four shows lah in one weekend lah. You have four organizers to talk to, and then you have a variety of the technical team lah, apa whatever promo lah. Then kau dah susah lah macam mana kau nak, bila kau nak plan kau punya practice, bila kau nak plan kau punya benda-benda lain kan. So kau punya logistik, kau nak pergi promo mana dulu, apa benda tu semua dulu. And then show kau, kau nak pergi sound, okay, satu hari kau ada dua show, maknanya kau ada dua soundcheck. So satu hari kau ada empat benda, then kau kena plan. That tu aku rasa kau perlukan manager lah, bila kau ada banyak benda. So someone to manage your, especially your timing lah, your schedule lah. And then and if kau dah ada band manager, kau, you can plan something lah. Macam okay, aku nak release album, so kau focus on production of your album. So your manager maybe can help you on to plan how to launch your album, things like that.
Alright, Pin, tadi aku kau baru cakap tadi bila let's say four shows in a weekend lah kan, where you have to talk to four different organizers. How do you deal with organizers yang semua nak korang main last?
Aku tengok first come lah. Okay, Kalau aku kena tengok, first aku kena tengok timing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, whether it's possible or not.
Yes.
Okay, first kalau dah memang wish list nak hujan main last. Tapi katakan show kau, satu aku kena main pukul 6, lagi satu last performance dia is after Isyak, let's say pukul 9. But satu dekat Shah Alam, satu dekat, you know, Seremban. It's not possible lah.
Yes,
you know.
True.
Aku kena, siapa yang masuk dulu, aku kena honor benda tu lah.
Yeah.
Then the second yang masuk, aku kena beritahu lah macam, okay, aku dah ada booking. And so aku dah, and dah confirm show ni. And so maksud gini, so aku boleh main show kau, tapi aku tak boleh main pukul 6 lah. Aku kena main pukul 3. And of course, the band needs rest as well. The team pun nak kena rest and kena set up, buat benda balik, baru balik kan. So benda-benda macam tu, it's all about negotiation and discussion lah dengan the organizers lah.
I mean, I ask you that out of the blue, because sometimes aku pun pernah face benda ni, whereas I was there to be an MC, but out of the sudden aku boom jadi stage manager, because stage manager dekat certain show or gig is nowhere to be seen. Lepas tu bila aku dah kena deal tu on the dot, tak pasal-pasal aku lah kena keluar phone aku, call-call orang and what not, and then end up like I did this voluntarily, kena marah pun bagai. Lepas tu pasal show slot semua, aku yang kena maki. Because aku fikir it's important lah, tak ada band manager pun, a certain bandmate at least have to act slightly a bit like that lah, to manage diorang punya slot. Whereas kalau ada organizer yang strict, yang kata macam, oh you came later than your slot, you either lose your slot or you play last, benda-benda tu pun boleh jadi gaduh. So I'm just saying here that what Ipin baru cakap tadi, please bear in mind, tak payah bear, keep it up here if you're playing in a band, because it will do you good, trust me. Cakap pasal do good,
Ipin, but lepas ni jangan buat benda volunteer. And last
minute. Oh, tak, that was I will always listen, because he dah kira, you know, we have a good relationship, because so, I know, refer to him juga in terms of work juga. Yeah. We've got that history. A certain current issue from a band that we all know, we all been in gigs together with them, have a certain issue with a certain producer. You aware of the case, eh?
No.
Oh, you're not aware of the case. So I mean,
aku tahu, aku tak tahu in detail lah.
Ah, okay. So, but you know that lah. But you know from what you've read, on the papers or on
aku
the internet.
Headline je.
Ah, you baca headline je. Okay, from the headline, you've got a slight small picture of what's going on.
Tak tahu.
Okay.
Aku tak boleh nak judge. Aku tak tahu detail kan. So
it's basically about not getting paid, and the issue's been stretched longer than expected. Benda-benda macam tu pernah jadi tak kat hujan?
Apa you have to be very specific.
Okay.
Well, apa benda yang pernah terjadi pada hujan? Letak tepi whatever current issue yang kau cakap tadi.
Yes.
Aku tak tahu benda pun kan. Apa benda yang pernah terjadi? Macam banyak benda yang pernah terjadi. So, I need to know specific apa benda yang kau maksudkan. So
I'm gonna be specific right now. In terms of payment. Has there been any delays to it, and delay tu selama mana, dan how do you handle it?
First, delay of course. Okay. Tak semua show kau akan main, habis show kau dapat full payment. Ada certain shows yang kau pun dah tahu. Macam, okay, let's say kau kena tahu some corporate companies, or let's say TV station, they have their own SOP.
Okay.
Sometimes it'll take you like 90 days untuk payment settle. Sometimes it can go longer. Benda tu standard. And then engkau macam aku tahu beforehand benda tu.
Yes.
Usually sekarang band pun tahu benda tu, because after our past experience kan, mula-mula kita tak tahu, agak kancang lah macam, eh apa benda ni kan. Sometimes kan, aku dah lupa dia payment apa ni kan. Tapi benda tu sekarang kita tahu lah. Okay, let's say katakan kau buat show for a certain TV station. Lepas show kau minta duit, memang kau pelakar lah. Memang semua gelak kat kau kan. Ini apa hal kan.
Yes, true.
So, but then now, ada je yang bagus sekarang ni. Kadang kau just wait like 2 weeks, dah dapat. So, kau kena tahu, let's say, concert. Then, a certain festival, yes, kau boleh dapat. Like, maybe 7 working days. Katakanlah, benda tu biasa. Ada show yang kau betul-betul, lepas show memang pump, transfer, ni receipt transfer, whatever kan. So, dia bagi cash or whatever. So ada benda-benda macam tu. So that's why engkau as aku, kerja aku ialah to make sure everything is in order lah. So bila band tanya, aku kena jawab lah. And then aku kena update orang lah. Okay, show ni memang lambat. Memang lambat. Sometimes ada yang extraordinary lambat.
Oh.
Which is, aku akan selalu tanya, eh macam mana lah. So dia akan cakap, okay kita ada sometimes diorang ni aku tak tahu. Aku tak pernah kerja corporate. So aku tak tahu sometimes yang aku assume ialah dia ada nak a certain amount ni ke apa benda, whatever, kau ada program or whatever. Untuk dapat payment tu kau kena lalu few bosses to sign.
Yeah.
So bila few bosses, katakan bosses ni busy. So dia oversee or whatever, cuti benda ni semua. So kau sebulan berapa satu. Tu yang jadi lama tu.
Yes.
Tapi I'm not talking about whatever yang kau tanya. It's not related.
Oh yeah, to nothing related to what I've hinted earlier. Yeah. But this
because
is all.
Aku jujur, aku tak tahu benda tu.
Yes.
Aku tak tahu benda yang.
Don't find it hard to believe. Ipin tak tahu, tak tahu lah.
Aku memang tak ambil ni sangat lah.
It's good, Ipin. It's actually good.
Aku ada masalah aku sendiri yang
yes.
Aku malah nak ambil tahu
at
masalah
this,
orang.
At this time, this day and age, we've got our own problems to face.
Yeah, I have two kids and a wife, you know.
Alhamdulillah.
So aku banyak benda fikir orang
lah. Okay, Ipin. Kalau cakap pasal extraordinary lama kan. Has it gone to a certain length where dia punya lambat tu like extraordinary? Do you have an assistant for you to
no,
follow
your,
up?
No, your
or you follow up yourself?
No, first extraordinary. Kau tak boleh cakap benda yang sangat subjektif tau.
Okay.
Kau punya extraordinary dengan aku extraordinary is very different. Dia I sama like macam cakap. Eh, aku pergi sini okay je. Aku tak suka benda tu.
Okay, betul.
Kau punya okay dengan aku punya okay lain. Yeah. Dia macam, eh, aku pergi sini, review dia dekat sini is 5 star. Then okay lah.
Okay lah.
Dia macam, eh, kau tengok movie lah eh. Eh, best tak cerita ni? Eh, aku okay.
Aku kena jawab macam tu. But I know how you are when it comes to movies.
Benda,
yes.
Apa benda tu kau?
Okay.
Macam, sama lah macam aku pergi
kan.
Oh, ni, dan ni pakai okay je. Aku macam, eh. Bentu lah. Aku tak okay je. Aku nak kena ikut dia okay kan.
Yes.
Kadang aku okay, bentu tak okay. So benda-benda yang subjektif ni kau kena. Kau kena macam okay. Bagi kau extraordinary lambat. Mungkin bagi kau is 2 weeks is extraordinary. But for me 2 weeks is normal.
Correct.
Maybe for me 1 year is extraordinary. But maybe for you 1 year is normal. Mungkin tahap kesabaran kau, iman kau tebal kan.
Good point.
So kau kena bagi okay. Kau kena bagi aku contoh. Pernah tak kau tunggu payment setahun? Sebagai contoh lah. Then I can answer lah.
Pernah ke?
Tak pernah.
Okay, Alhamdulillah.
Setahun Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Sepanjang aku jaga, seingat aku tak pernah.
Then we all know here that we all know the efficiency of you lah. But also relating to my second part tadi lah, do you have anyone to assist you on that?
Assist in terms of
in terms sense? Of okay, let's say okay, tak pernah setahun kan. Let's say if close to setahun lah. If you have others to follow up with, but you kind of tak cukup tangan at that time being lah, not every time. Do you have anyone to like follow up for you, or do you do everything yourself?
In terms of payment, aku sendiri.
Good.
Sebab, okay, first, kau kena tahu dengan siapa kau bekerja and siapa yang boleh hutang kau.
Correct.
Let's say, macam aku cakap tadi, yang usually yang aku okay untuk payment a term, usually is a corporate company. Atau TV station. Because kita tahu.
Yes.
Dia tak boleh tipu kau siul. Kau tak boleh. If kau deal dengan whoever lah, TV3 ke apa benda, itu memang SOP dia orang. Ada kontrak. And kau tak boleh nak cakap dia, kau jumpa producer TV3 tu, kau cakap, let's say, eh akak nak buat kau punya big talk lah, kak saya nak 70% payment. Kau dia, benda tu memang tak boleh kan?
Kena gelak dulu lah sebelum kena marah.
Benda tu memang agak impossible lah.
Yes.
Kan? Unless kau, I don't know, maybe you can pull strings or whatever. But aku tak boleh lah.
I doubt I can, so, but like you
benda
said
tu,
lah.
Tapi katakan orang yang some ABC Entertainment nak panggil kau, big, aku nak buat kau punya show, aku nak buat show gini. Tapi payment kau after 3 bulan aku bayar. Jangan lah. Kan? So kau tak tahu kan?
Yes, correct.
And then everything, whatever it is, aku akan ambil apa-apa hal, deposit lah ke macam tu lah, something to secure lah kan?
Yes.
And then kau kena buat background check that company.
So apa part shows dia and yeah, siapa dia pernah buat, siapa supplier pernah buat kerja dengan dia, and then tengoklah dia punya financial flow dia okey ke tak before this 3 bulan ke benda-benda ke. Tapi aku sangat jarang untuk company or agency yang aku tak kenal untuk aku ambil term lah. Macam okay, tak apa kau boleh bayar aku 50% in 3 months time or whatever, no. Unless macam aku cakap lah, contohnya TV station and corporate company pun depends, sangat jarang lah. Macam you know, let's say agency, macam sometimes aku tak faham kak, macam kau ada agency kan? Okay, let's say katakan corporate company hire agency untuk kau buat kerja. Okay, aku bagi contoh, aku tak bagi contoh hujan lah, aku bagi contoh kau. Okay,
go ahead.
Aku client ni, aku katakan aku some oil and gas company lah, kita nak bagi gah sikit kan. So kita, aku hire Highcastle as agency.
Okay,
Highcastle ambil kau.
Okay,
okay, untuk jadi MC. So kau dah jadi lah, kau dah buat MC benda ni semua. Tapi aku kena bayar Highcastle 3 bulan. Tapi aku tak faham kenapa kau kena tunggu 3 bulan. Faham tak?
Faham. Yes, yes.
What's the point of having an agency?
Correct.
Kan? Kalau kau kena tunggu payment daripada aku, main
beri darat ya? Yes.
Kan? So kadang-kadang benda-benda tu yang, itu soalan untuk aku lah. Aku macam sometimes aku tak faham. So aku macam, ya usah lah. Kan? Kenapa kau kena ada agency? Sekali lagi sekarang dah 2020 je. Macam dulu, kau kena ada agency because kau tak tahu siapa yang buat benda ni. Because now, okay, let's say kalau certain companies, kau nak a certain benda, can just Google, everything is there.
Oh yes.
Okay, let's say if you want hujan, especially, you just go to Instagram hujan, ada nombor telefon aku situ.
Yeah.
Can just go direct lah. You save money, kan?
Yes,
so, sometimes agency bagus. Kan, agency ada kantapau semua benda. Tapi jangan lah suruh talent kau tunggu payment. Bila lah payment? Kita tak dapat lagi payment ni. Itu kau settle lah dengan dia. You as an agency kena ada some certain, aku tak tahu, maybe for me.
Before we close the show, kita dah di penghujung rancangan. If you're let me just say before I ask the last question, it's good to know things beforehand.
Yeah.
Kalau nak deal apa-apa pun. Because if you just listen to what Ipin had to say, it's all very useful information. Alright. So Ipin, maybe an advice or kata-kata penutup untuk band-band di luar sana atau kawan-kawan yang nampak kerjaya manage band ni sebenarnya satu benda yang baik. What have you got to say to them?
First is hard work. Kau kena ada mindset bagi aku lah. Aku selalu tengok benda, music is a business. Aku tak fikir passion. Aku dah way past passion about how to put food on the table. I need to treat the band as a product. Okay, not just the music. Maknanya the bandmates, the whatever is a product. The team, the brand, the ni semua is a product. It's like kau tak boleh ada mindset yang, oh aku kerja dengan rock band, aku boleh rock and roll. The band can rock and roll whatever they want lah. But then kau kena at least fikir on how to market the band in a sense lah kan. So yeah, it's a good, I think best kau flexible and whatnot, but then it's hard work lah. It's hard work and like you said, dedication, and of course you need passion. Macam aku tak ada that teenage life yang party benda tu. Aku tak ada benda tu. Aku memang kerja kan. But then aku grateful dengan, alhamdulillah, dengan apa yang Allah dah bentangkan untuk aku. Aku jumpa wife aku pun because daripada aku kerja dengan orang, then aku kenal wife aku. So and I'm happily married now, so alhamdulillah. So kau kena trust benda tu, and then kau kena trust the band lah. Kau kena trust the band and trust the music. Let's say katakan kau ada show macam kau kan, kau let's say big as an MC, katakan orang datang, big boleh tak tolong jadi MC untuk event aku, tapi aku ada bajet 500 je big, then how? You need to value yourself. Kalau kau rasa kau value for RM500, then kau worth RM500 lah. But then you need to justify lah.
Yeah.
Okay, they say, oh tak boleh lah, harga big ialah RM2,500.
Because gini. That's how you ego lah. That's why so aku value hujan an X amount. It's not just the band, the team, whatever the package comes with it.
Yeah.
That's why you need to bila orang bayar kau, okay, let's say dia bayar kau, okay, tak apa, ambil aku, aku nak kau, aku bayar kau RM2,500. Then bila kau deliver, dia akan macam, at least worth lah aku bayar kau RM2,500 instead of RM500. You know, you pay peanuts, you get monkeys kan. Yeah. So things like that lah. So untuk, if kau nak jadi band manager, sila teruskan lah kan. Cuma kalau boleh, pergi yang kau boleh. Sekarang ada course music business apa benda semua, which is sangat bagus lah. Aku tak masuk, aku belajar lain, aku kerja lain.
So apa pun, street smart pun.
So tapi tak, if kau ada orang yang music, pergi music business and things like that, it's a bonus point lah.
Yeah.
Because you know all this, kau belajar lah all this royalties lah, apa benda ni semua. Tu matematik bagi lah aku. Ganam lah benda tu kan. Aku matematik susah sikit. Aku kira duit aku okay.
Macam sama kita. Tapi kira okay lah. Kira ya.
Kalau ada RM depan kau okay. Boleh congak kan. Tapi kalau aku rasa aku kira
RM, number tu kita faham kan. Dapat notification dah transfer. Oh, understand this value.
But then tu lah kau, whoever yang aku nak manage, aku kena suka dulu band tu.
Yes.
Aku tak boleh, let's say katakan aku dah tak manage Hujan, katakan satu hari kan, tiba-tiba kau nak manage tapi kau tak suka. Tapi just kau nampak, weh, aku ni nampak boleh bikin duit ni. So dia susah sikit.
Untuk
aku lah, katakan kau bikin band, kau rasa aku manage kan. Aku, kalau aku tak suka band kau, aku akan cakap, sorry Vic, aku tak minat lah lagu kau. Because untuk aku, bila aku tak suka, aku tak tahu macam mana nak value kau.
Yes, untuk aku juga, I can understand. But maybe some others out there akan melenting ke apa
dia
ke.
Kena faham lah.
Yeah, kena faham lah sekarang.
And then when it comes to kerja, let's say ada orang kat luar sana, dia nak manage band kawan dia, dia kena tahu bila dia kerja, dia kena kerja. Tu bukan kawan lu.
Yes.
Bila kerja,
penting ni.
Empat orang ni bukan member dah. Bila kita masuk kerja, orang kira bos lah. Aku kena treat orang as a bos lah. Habis kerja kita lepak lah.
Yes.
Habis bila kerja kita kerja. Dia persefahaman tu yang kena ada lah. Because kau pun pernah kerja dengan aku apa?
Yeah.
Bila aku kerja, aku kerja lah. Kau, aku treat kau as talent lah.
Yes, correct.
If kau lambat, kau kena lah. Kan? Kalau aku nak kau pukul 2, dua aku nak kau, kau jangan.
Yes.
So aku tak suka macam aku, macam benda-benda macam tu lah, macam. Tapi aku tak ada macam aku benci sial diri. Tak ada macam aku petang kerja, kita kerja.
You being professional, I don't see anything wrong with that.
Bila kau kerja dulu, lepas tu pun nombor 2 kawan mah.
Of course.
Aku kan datang nak booking kawan. Aku datang nak kerja kan.
No, kawan is kawan. But at the end of the day, kawan tak bayar gaji kita.
Yes.
Tu pun satu jugalah. So by that, Ipin, aku dari Wakil High Castle from the Big Talk would like to thank you very much for this eye-opening interview.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for your insights. We hope to maybe... maybe talk further more ke apa, you never know. Maybe your own talk show?
No.
You mention mock-up, you know, maybe you will produce your own talk show, no?
I can produce, but I'm not going to be the MC lah.
No lah, I don't think. You can be, but me and you, kita dah boleh gelak-gelak dah. But then again, bila kerja tak jadi kawan, bro. Macam mana, kita MC dengan kawan. But then again, thank you very much. That's the end of the Big Talk. Once again, shout-outs to Ipin, manager of Hujan, Fork and Spoon. You know, Fork and Spoon Entertainment. Alright, so apa-apa... Nak contact Ipin apa job?
Boleh, aku sekarang ni sebab aku free. So aku okay semua.
Instagram apa, Pin?
Ipin Ahmad.
E-P-A-I-N, Pin sakit, Ipin Ahmad. At Ipin Ahmad. So any production services ke, man management ke apa ke, the man. Alright, so remember,
driver boleh.
Alamak, dia sudah dah, okay, dia dah rewind 10 tahun lepas ni. Remember, dream big, think big, go big. Every Thursdays 9 PM, don't forget to subscribe High Castle Studio on YouTube, y'all. This is us signing out. Assalamualaikum.